What's good, y'all? Stopped by, got me some pizza real quick. Want to talk to y'all for a second about knowing you got to know when to let go. I really don't have an answer for you on how to know when to let go, but to be honest, I don't think there's really a certain way to define it. You just gotta, if you ask anybody who actually walked away from somebody, you know, they just did it one day. There's not no like certain time, like a lot of people think that something's gonna happen and then that's when I'm gonna leave them. Like something bad's going to happen and they're going to piss me off to the point that, you know, I'm just not going to be able to stand them anymore and I'm just going to walk away from them and this and that. Well, there's a lot of problems going on with that. A lot of times people feel like they can't walk away because they have kids and or they live with somebody, you know, a lot of things going on. So you can't, a lot of times people feel like they're not just in the position to just walk away. And then, as we all know, people can cheat, people can lie, you know, do you dirty, and you still stay because they still make you happy because the attachment, you know, makes you happy. It's even though they make you sad and hurt and shit, they make you happy with the fact that you have somebody. You know, that's what it really boiled down to. It's not necessarily that the person that treats you like shit makes you happy. It's the fact that you are not alone that makes you happy. You know what I'm saying? You have somebody. It's that feeling of that I ain't gonna call it fake love, but basically that's what it is. If somebody's treating you wrong or cheating on you and shit like that, it is fake love, man. It can't be real. But since you're still attached to the person, you still get that dope hit. You still get that crack hit, man. So you're going to stay. That's why people stay with people who cheat, man. I've done it before. Who hasn't done it before? You stay because of the feel. It's not about the person make you happy at that point. It's the fact that they do make you happier than being alone. So you stay. But the problem with this is you love somebody so much, right? You love somebody so hard. Then when you find the right person, it's like they don't even get that from you. I'm going to say that again for everybody that's going to watch this video. The problem with that stand loving long shit is you love somebody so hard. Then you, let's say you find the right person the next time or whatever. They not even going to get all that you gave to that wrong person, man. That's why. And you know why? Because you didn't walk away. Simple and plain, man. You didn't walk away. When you seen them cheat, you should have walked. Now, I know most people don't do that. That's a tough thing. Because you could be living with them. You could have kids with them. I get it, man. I get it. But eventually, y'all going to break up anyway. So, if I know people watching this video are going to listen. And they still not going to do it. I get it. Because I wouldn't. If I was you. If I was one of y'all. That's why I'm scared to get close to somebody, because they could do me wrong and I probably would just say, you know what, I ain't gonna leave them, fuck you. I'm gonna deal with it, you know. I don't know now that I'm a different animal now. I'm a different breed now. I might actually walk away, or I'll just downgrade their ass, but that's not walking away. So, but yeah, man, it's like giving somebody your all, man. You don't get over that, because I don't know how I did it, how I got over it, but I know I'm talking about other people I see. Like, they're going to give so much to that person. And then when they try to like somebody else later, after they break up with that person that they keep giving their all to, letting them run you in the dirt, you know, you're not going to be able to love the next person as much as you love them. And that's what's fucked up about it. Think about it. The wrong person got the best version of love of you than the next person. Ain't that some shit? That's what's going on a lot out here, y'all. You have people who have loved somebody super hard at one point, it didn't work, and now they don't love nobody. Now they refuse to love anybody, or they subpar love somebody, or whatever. You know what I'm saying? They're not giving somebody the best version. You know, like me, I feel like I'm a love harder, right? I feel like I'm a love harder. I use it as motivation that it didn't work before with somebody. But most people, they're not going to do that. They're going to get drained so much that they can't love like that no more. And it's called an imprint, where you can't get over somebody. You can't get over the baby daddy or the baby mama or whatever, because you went so hard with them. And that's why you got to know when to pull the plug, man. And I know that people say, yeah, they cheat on me, I'm leaving. But 99.9% of the time, motherfuckers don't leave when somebody cheats on them, man. Or do them dirty and shit, or treat them like shit, they stay. Because the dope hit, man. The dope hit. You're used to something. This is the danger of attachment, man. Everybody say it's love, and oh man, I ain't trying to deal with no fucking dog, man. And then you run right in front of me though. Stupid ass dog. Man, where the fuck that dog go, man? Man, that's a big ass dog too, man. It's a pit too, man. Son of a bitch. I'm trying to get up out of here with this. Guess I'm about to make this video longer now. Cause I'm not trying about to get out with that damn pit, man. Fuck. Hell no. Nah. Man, I'm gonna get out, but not yet. But yeah, man, I know people, they not trying to hear this shit, man. Because, you know, you could listen to a video like this and be like, yeah, he right, man. You got to learn when to let it go, because if you don't, you ain't going to be able to love the next person the same, but you still going to run back to that dope hit, man. Let's be honest about it. This is why I'm scared to, not really scared to get attached to somebody, but this is why I'm hesitant. Because if you do get attached to somebody, shit like this happened, they could get away with almost anything. And you're going to deal with it because of the attachment. You don't want to deal with starting over. You don't want to deal with being alone. But the problem is, you keep loving the wrong person, it takes more out of you. It takes more and more out of you the more you stay and try to make it work with the wrong person. That's not how the right person is probably going to be more smooth, I feel. I don't think I know, because I'm not sure if I had the right person. But I'm pretty damn sure it ain't gonna be no shit that I've seen or that I see other people going through. Ain't no fucking way. If that's the case, then who the fuck wants love then, right? I don't believe that. I think people, when they with the wrong people, that's when you get this draining shit and back and forth, always arguing. This shit is crazy, man. Getting along for a minute, now you're not meant to be together probably, man. It just is what it is. But people are going to fight for that because they have already invested in it. That's number one. Number two, they keep believing it's just nobody's perfect. So just keep working at it. We going to get better. Yeah, nobody's perfect. But some of that shit, man, it ain't supposed to be like that, man. You know what I mean? You know, you got to know when to pull the plug. I don't have the answer. That's another thing. I do not have the answer on when you should pull the plug on somebody. You're going to have to figure that out. And unfortunately, a lot of people don't figure it out until it's way too late. Too much damage has been done to them. And it affects them with the other pair bonding with the next person. Period, man. But ain't nobody talking about this shit, man. Ain't nobody talking about this shit. This is why you see a lot of women who have been hurt by a lot of men. They can't pair bond with nobody no more, man. I mean, they could, but it'd be extremely hard because they've been beat down so much, man. Same thing with a lot of men. So that's why you see a lot of men just sleeping around. You know, they probably try love a few times, man, and they let somebody beat them down too much, man. So now they don't want love. These are cold, hard facts, people. But again, there's people right now, bad relationships right now, who will watch this video, and they're still going to go back to their crack hit. They still going to hit that crack, man. Because that crack gives them that high, man. And that's just the truth. And that's why you got to be careful about who you get attached to. See, it's okay to take the crack hit if I'm attached to the right woman, right? It don't matter. You're supposed to be. That's supposed to be. But the problem is, we got too many attached to the wrong ones. And that's why you seeing them argue, fight all the time, and go through that, all this shit. And to a lot of people, they're going to say that that's what love is, and you ain't nothing perfect. You're supposed to go through that, man. You ain't supposed to beat each other down like that, man. I mean, maybe some people make it out of that shit, and if they do, then great. They'd probably be some of the best loving motherfuckers in the world then. But, you know, most people, for the most part, nah, they're going to end up broken up, especially if there's no kids involved and shit like that. Just keeping them there. You know what I mean? But people are always going to go for that. Go back to that crack hit, man. They're going to take that hit of crack. Because that's what they're used to. I'm dead serious. It's like trying to quit smoking weed or something. Then when you smoke that blunt, you feel good again. That's what it is. The bad person is a bad drug. It's a bad drug. And nobody want to hear it. That's why it'll go in one ear and out the other. I ain't worried about what Twan said. Such as just hit me up. He just hit me up right now. And she gonna go for it. It just is what it is, man. Now, it would be nice if it was the right person that people are attached to. That's a whole different ball game. But most people are not attached to the right person, man. And they not gonna pull that plug until they're drained. And then the next person in line don't get the same type of love they get. They gave the wrong person. Because they went super hard for that one. It's fucked up. But that's what the fuck's going on. Maybe she's a mother of three kids. You really think? It's possible. If she's ready, maybe she was single for a long time. You really think, though, she could give you that same type of energy that she gave to a husband? It's going to be tough. Super tough. Because that husband and her trying to make it work with him and all that shit, that drained her, man. That's why you got to take a break after a breakup. That's why it's called rebound, because the person who's just breaking up with somebody, going to somebody else, they don't have what it takes to give you what you deserve yet. They can't do it yet, man, because they've been drained. But some people are drained to the point that they can't even, not only can they not give it to a rebound, they might not ever be able to give it to anybody else ever again like they did to the wrong person. All because they didn't know when to pull the plug, man. I don't have the answer for when to pull the plug. Everybody's situation is different. But I think, like, when you get cheated on, you should pull the plug. I don't know why people are not doing it. Because they hoping that it's going to change. And I'm telling you right now, I've just seen it. It's happened to me 3 different times. In the end, what happened? I end up leaving them. Walking away, right? Plus, you're really not happy with the person that cheated on you. You know, you just tolerating it. But you, deep down in your mind, you know what they did. And it makes you feel a certain way. But you're going to ignore that because you want that crack hit. As bad as it makes you feel, like, damn, she cheated on me, I feel like her bitch. Or he cheated on me, I feel like whatever. As bad as that makes you feel, the comfort of that crack hit makes you feel comfortable and possibly even better. That's why you stay. Because being alone don't feel good, so you're not going to want to do that. You know? But being alone feels better than being with the wrong person. And being alone is better than holding on to the wrong person and letting it drain you more and more. It's best to leave with the less damage possible. You know when it's time, but you don't want to accept it. I knew when it was time, like, damn, I got to leave this girl. But I ain't want to leave the girl. And the same thing go for short term or whatever. It don't even have to be a relationship. It could be a talking stage. Like, she really flaked on me 2 times. Yeah, you got to leave her alone. Shit, really, 1 time for real. Remember, the quicker you pull that plug, the less damage. But people ain't doing that shit, man. So we're not just talking about relationships, man. This shit is, it could be somebody you just met. The better you get rid of them, the better you realize, all right, she's full of shit. She lied, you know, or something like that. The better off you are, because you could hold on to them and then miss out on the right person. Or they could be draining you of your energy, aka feelings or whatever, attachment, and the right person come along, but you're attached to this person because you didn't cut them off when you seen the red flag, the super red flags. So it ain't just about marriage and long-term relationships, you know. But it's even worse the longer it is. They really got it bad because even if they want to leave, they probably can't. You know, it's going to take a whole lot of strength within for them to walk away. And like I said in the beginning of the video, it ain't like, you know, people are waiting on this person to do that. And if they fuck up one more time, they do one bad thing, that's it. That's not how it works, man. You just say one day, you know what, I'm not even fuck with that person no more. It happens like that. It don't happen because, you know, one more thing and then that's it. Because you would have left the last time they did one more thing. You're going to keep saying that shit. Like Eminem said, this time you promised to show your strength. Life ain't no Nintendo game or something. Walk out window pane. I forget how he said it. But the point of what he's saying is you're promising yourself and you're promising a person, you know, you do this or whatever, I'm gone or whatever. You know what I mean? But it don't even never work that way. It just, over time, you just get tired of the shit, man. And you just leave them alone. That's how it really go. But what I just said about you get tired over time and you leave them alone, you got to know when to leave them alone. You got to know when to pull that plug. I think a lot of people get confused and scared. Like, man, if I leave, what if it's a mistake and this and that's not a mistake if somebody's cheating on you, man, or cheated on you. It's not a mistake to leave them. It's already over. You're just buying extra time. I've said this before. It's already over. When a woman cheats, let's say the woman cheated on me, it's over. I can hold on as long as I want or as long as I possibly can, but it's really over. Like, legitimately, it's over. But we don't want to accept it, so we want to hold on to shit. We want that crack hit. Yeah, I'm going to call it a crack hit because that's probably what it is. Love probably strong as crack. I don't know. Never tried it. But I know love some strong ass shit. Or feelings or attachment. It don't even be love half the time. It be fucking attachment. Motherfuckers hate each other and still together. It's attachment, man. Kids and stuff like that. They ain't no fucking love. Love don't treat each other like shit. Love don't have conditions. You know, oh shit, she's about to leave. Let me act right. Oh, she's back. Now I got her. All right, let me go back to doing what I was doing. Play PlayStation and ignore her and all this other shit. It's ridiculous, man. But hey, it is what it is, man. And I don't know what to tell y'all, man. You know, just watch out. That's all I can say. So I'm going to get off here, man. Get in the house. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And I hope y'all have a good day. You know what I'm saying? What's that say? Oh, shit, that's old. No one to let go because if not, like I said, man, not only will it possibly make it to where you can't love the next person as much or more than the wrong person, you know, you can't feel it back from them. It's like it's not good enough. Because you're so disappointed from what happened before. You're so drained from what we happened before. That imprint is so deep that it's hard to reciprocate another person. That's what's happening with a lot of females that you see that have dealt with men and had a lot of disappointment. It's hard for them to reciprocate a solid-ass dude. So a lot of them, let me be the bad bitch. Let me talk to different men. Let me do what these men did to me, basically. Some do it knowingly, some do it ignorantly. Don't even know why they doing it. You know what I'm saying? On to the next one, man. Good night, y'all.